So you all know I'm a substitute today. I think the history of the Wiley, you can read it on the plaque, and that is, it's the high points of our history. But in my mind, history is more about the people involved, the people on the ship, the people that built the ship, the people that opposed the ship when we were in the Pacific. And we've got a really interesting and full history there. And since the war, I would say starting 45 years after the war, when Bill Zins organized our first reunion, we have become a very close-knit group, and we have learned that our survival in the Pacific really was because, as Captain Bjarnason once said, nobody screwed up at crucial moments. And I think that there's a lot to that. I mean, we all managed to do our jobs in critical moments. And that is not to say that we didn't make lots of mistakes, because I know myself that I made a lot of mistakes, but none of them led, fortunately, to anything too bad. The ship left Brooklyn Navy Yard. I'm leaving out the early part about the commissioning, the training crews to Bermuda, which unfortunately I missed. I was not on the ship that time. But we left Brooklyn Navy Yard in 1944, in the fall of 44, and we joined a big task force that went from Casco Bay, Maine, where we sort of collected, down through the Panama Canal and out into the Pacific. We stopped in San Diego, our ship did, for about a week, and then we headed for Pearl Harbor. And by this time, they started practicing for the invasion of Iwo Jima. We went through 2 months of practice bombardment, practice anti-aircraft. We shot up Kalawi Island, which was uninhabited except for a few goats. That was one thing about our first skipper. He was a wonderful organizer and trainer of men, and I think he trained the crew of the Wiley, so they were performing very well. We left Pearl Harbor finally in, I think it was January, might have been early February of 1945. On the way out to Iwo Jima, we stopped at Enewetok, we stopped briefly at Saipan, and then we escorted the battleship New York up to Iwo Jima 3 days before the invasion. And then we started, well, the next more than 3 months, excuse me, 3 weeks, we were bombarding. We expended 4 5-inch shells bombarding at Iwo Jima than any other destroyer type except our sister ship, the Fraser. And we were on bombardment duty about a third of the time, close to Mount Suribachi, and the picture, which is going, is, I haven't seen the plaque, but is on our plaque, it shows the Wiley, Henry A. Wiley, at the base of Mount Suribachi. And we spent about a third of our time in Iwo Jima, in and around that mountain, southern end of Iwo Jima. We went from there to Ulithi, where we massed together with hundreds, I think it was over 1,000 ships of U.S., British, and Australian ships that were passing for the invasion of Okinawa. We left early with the minecraft. We had been converted to a mine layer, and from a destroyer, the whole squadron of 12 were converted. We were officially attached to the minecraft, and we were sent up 7 days before the invasion of Okinawa to support the mine sweepers, destroy mines that were cut and came to the surface, and otherwise perform as a destroyer. It was strange that they went through all this conversion of our ship when they were building it to a mine layer, and then we never really laid a mine. We laid buoys in mine sweeping operations, but marked the sweeping operations. Anyway, we were at Okinawa, and I 7 days before, we starting the last days of March, in 1945, we encountered the first of the bad kamikaze attacks on ships, and we were extremely active on March 28th, 29th, 30th, and April 1st, with altogether shooting down at that time. In those days, six Japanese planes, and having a lot of sort of narrow escapes. During the rest of the Okinawa campaign, I abbreviated, we did patrolling duty, a little bombardment duty, lots of radar picket duty, where we were stationed 40 or 50 miles off of Okinawa, and during the daytime we had a combat air patrol of five planes. They were marine aviators that were based by then on landing fields in the Okinawa region that would be our combat air patrol. And when we picked up on the radar enemy planes coming in, we would vector our fighter director officer, Bill Maureen. I'm sorry he's not here. He was our fighter director officer, and vector planes out to intercept the Japanese planes. Unfortunately, about 10 times or more, there were 75 to 100 Japanese planes coming in at once, and four combat air patrol had a hard time with, outnumbered by the Japanese planes, but they did a wonderful job for us. And one incident that I will just briefly mention was on May 4th, 1945, we were sent out to replace a sinking ship, the destroyer Luce, on a picket station. And when we got out there, the Luce was sinking and actually sank. This was in the morning, and there were survivors in the water. The planes that were buzzing over the Luce turned their attention to us and attacked us, and we managed in a very short time, in less than a half an hour, to shoot down two winged bombs, Baka bombs, that were released from twin engine bombers, Bettys. And then we shot down, in addition to that, three other Japanese planes. But one plane came in on us from the other side. We were shooting, all our guns were firing on one side. And this kamikaze plane dove down, and a marine aviator came down on his tail and came through our fire. We were firing some of the smaller guns that this diving come up. But the Marine aviator shot him down and pulled out of his dive and waved at us. It was our great good fortune to locate this man 45 years after the war was over. Bob Muse, his name was, a remarkable man, and was the only Japanese plane he shot down in the war. But he saved us from being hit essentially. Well, we went through almost 5 months at Okinawa, and then before the end of the Okinawa campaign, we were doing minesweeping operations in the East China Sea and then off of Kyushu. Altogether, we were in 12 minesweeping operations. And finally, I won't go through any more, I've taken too long. We sailed, left in January of 46, come back to the States, and we stopped at Pearl Harbor. And to our good fortune, again, we picked up John Tierney, Pearl Harbor. So he is one of our shipmates that we're very proud of, and just happy that he was on the ship too, and we came into San Francisco. And essentially that is the history of our ship, but again, I just want to say that it's the people, in my mind, that were on the ship particularly that I feel so close to. I think our friendship has been a wonderful experience for me.